Who are you guys?
Good morning, students.
How many of you are existing previous sea monkeys and just came to hear me say that?
If you are you were on the JoCo cruise, if you meant to be on a different cruise, you were on the wrong cruise ship. Now is a good time to leave before the ship leaves port. Feeling that, welcome. We're very glad to have you here. How many, show of hands, how many people actually knew first-time sea monkeys?
All right.
Wow.
Yeah.
You guys answered the ad.
There's an ad.
My name is Jonathan Coulton. This is
the titular
member of the crew, Jonathan Coulton. These are Paul and Storm. If you can't tell them apart, this is Paul and that one's Storm. Along with Drew Westfall, not pictured. The four of us are the people who run this thing, along with all of the various other members that help us out. We want to have this little opportunity to meet you guys and talk with you guys because...
Because this thing is scary.
It is kind of scary. I will tell you that I'm a professional entertainer who, you know... Who makes a living by appearing to be comfortable talking to people, but I'm not always comfortable talking to people. And when I, in the course of my career, find myself at various conventions or events with large groups of people wearing badges, I find it often excruciating and terrifying. This is all true. I say that because I trust there's some kindred spirits out there. It's the scariest thing in the world when there's a thing that's been going on for a long time and you're there and you don't know anybody and there's a group of people, a little circle of people talking, and you're standing over here with the hummus table having some hummus and some vegetables, and you kind of, sometimes you sidle up to a circle and you stand hopefully with a kind of a smile on your face. And then, how do you smile? Who am I? And then the group is just,
Inside reference.
So I will tell you that this group of people is truly a wonderful, friendly, open community. The people who have been here several years in a row work very hard to be welcoming. It's not if you think you're seeing a clickiness or people giving you the stiff arm, you're probably wrong. Everybody here is super nice. And it's
except for that guy.
That guy's kind of nice.
Jimmy Stiffarm, everybody. Jimmy Stiffarm.
But it's very true. It's very true that the simplest solution is often the best, which is just to go up and say, "Hi, my name is," and then you say your name. And you can even say, "This is my first JoCo cruise," and they'll be like, "Hey!" And all your problems will be solved. So that's the first thing I have to say to you. But we do have, I want to point you to the back page of this guide, which is, if you've already registered and gotten this fantastic cooler bag.
I like these bags.
This is why we do it, everybody. Yeah. It's a free cooler
bag. My bag is cooler.
On the back of the Sea Monkey magazine.
Periodical.
This is a new thing this year. We've never published a thing that looks this nice and has this many pages before. It was not expensive at all. Don't worry. We're doing fine. On the back is a section called New Monkey Information, which is just a couple of key things that you may need to know that will help you sort of acclimate to being here and try to... We're trying to help you help yourselves to figure out what the hell is going on.
Help us help you. Help you.
So I'm going to turn it over to Paul and Storm here, who can talk about some of these details in some small detail.
And that said, any time during the week, if you have any questions, maybe they weren't answered in the Sea Monkey, we have the Extraordinary Helper Monkeys, who are our volunteer folks.
All of the any working helper monkey will be wearing a brightly neon-colored lanyard that says "Helper Monkey" on it. You can just find any of them; they're happy to take whatever possible problem
you
are
having.
My phone is ringing.
Phone is ringing.
Jesus, take over, Scott.
Yes. So help the monkeys to answer your questions, and also, they're equipped to handle really any situation, and they're only a phone call to the max to getting our attention. As you can see, very seriously.
Right now, even in the middle of the goddamn shire. Yes. So yeah, don't hesitate to ask for help from any of the helper monkeys or indeed any of us if you see us. So let's see, what are the things that we need to talk about back here?
Well, the instructor of JoCo Cruise, in case you aren't generally familiar, basically three different things plus a whole pile on top of that. Mm-hmm. But the basic thing is almost every day we have a main featured event, which will either be here or in Studio B, which is the ice rink. And it can be a little tricky to find it, but you'll find a map in the Sea Monkey that will help guide you to it. And it'll become intuitive by the seventh day.
What I miss?
Is the fire off?
Nothing. Fire's out. Everything taken care of?
Your wife is still alive, thanks to me.
Oh, great. That's good news.
Remote CPR.
Why did they call you?
Because I'm the guy.
Right, I guess.
We are describing the general form of the event and have gone over the main events that they are here in the All Amphitheater Theater and in Studio B.
And if they haven't pointed yet, in the center of your Sea Monkey is a handy-dandy grid that outlines both all of the main events, which is basically every event that everybody can fit in these big venues. There's also some secondary official events, the writing track and the gaming track, which are new this year, as well as for some of the appearances by the featured acts, people who don't necessarily have their own main stage show but are here to entertain you nonetheless in various ways. So that's your best place to look to find out what is going on when, at least on the official calendar.
And just to let you off the hook, you will not be able to do everything.
Yeah.
And it's okay.
Yeah.
The every year it's gotten a little bit more complex because there are just so many great people here doing so many great things. I recommend that you attend the things you want to attend, skip the things you want to skip. Make sure you leave some time to actually be on a cruise ship. It's not an unpleasant thing. we try to have a little something for everybody, but not everything for everybody. If that makes sense.
Also, another really key part of the cruise that evolved naturally and that is wonderful how it's grown is something that is generally called the Shadow Cruise, where there are venues and times and spaces that we have where we've set aside for any Sea Monkey who wants to hold an event. And some of these events have been going for years, there are new ones every year, and you'll find information about that from the Game Room, sponsored by Steve Jackson. You can go down there.
Did we mention he's on the ship this year?
So you can go to the Game Room and there will be a lot of information about what's going on. There is Twitt-arrr, the onboard service also developed by Sea Monkeys.
We crowdsourced it.
Yeah. And
you don't need to, just be clear, you don't need to have the internet package to use Twitt-arrr. Twitt-arrr is a self-contained
It runs on the network, but not on the internet.
Right.
Yeah, the ship in Royal Caribbean, they worked with us to be able to give us that capability because of this.
And then there is also an app for all the major smart devices called Cruise Monkey, which is also user-developed in-house. Instructions for finding those and then hooking them up correctly to your particular device are all found within your Sea Monkey.
And finally, every night except for tonight, we'll be producing a very brief version of the Sea Monkey newsletter because things change throughout the week, times may change a little bit, events may be added, things like, we call them office hours, where the performers and featured guests might be like, hey, now I'm going to be in the pooty-poo bar at 4 o'clock, come join me.
The pooty-poo bar is the best bar on the ship, by the way.
Listen to this man. He knows the bars.
Oh, can I say a word about the performers? So here's the thing. I like famous people. I love famous people. It's awesome to meet your heroes and people who make work that you admire and love. It's sometimes a tricky thing, the interaction with the famous people, because you feel like you don't want to you don't want to intrude, you're maybe nervous, and...
But this may also be your only shot, so you gotta do it.
I will say that it's a really chill vibe. We're gonna be here all week, so you don't need to pounce on, Ted Leo the moment you see him. And in fact, because you will see him many more times later throughout the week. Probably you'll see him at the buffet getting some miso soup.
And also, I believe on Thursday night, he will be giving piggyback rides, so you will be able to find something. He doesn't know about this yet, so maybe not mention it.
So, a lot of cons are about, like, photo lines and autograph lines, which I personally find, like, not so great. Like, it's not the way I want to spend my time waiting in line to get a picture with somebody. Here's how I recommend you spend your time and effort this week, which is to have real interactions with people, including the famous people. Again, like, go up and say, "Hi, my name is Jonathan. I love your work." Don't say Jonathan, that's my name.
Unless your name is Jonathan.
Unless your name is Jonathan.
If it is.
But really, just go up and say, hi, it's me, I love your stuff. And that's a fantastic way to start a conversation. And it doesn't, because sometimes the relationship between famous person and fan can be kind of fraught and weird. And one of the things we love about this event is that by the end of the week, it's going to feel like we're all at a summer camp together. We've all been through the same hellish experience. So really, relax, have a good time. Don't worry about the moment, because you're going to get plenty of moments, I promise. It's going to be great. Oh, and one other thing. There is kind of a weird gray area sometimes between public and private time. You know, there are good times to approach famous people, and there are bad times to approach famous people. If they seem to be having an argument with their spouse, maybe that's the time to give them a little space. If they're
asleep in their cabin.
Just out of the pool and toweling off, maybe don't approach them right then.
Just marvel at them from afar.
As I like to say, just be cool. Just be cool. It's all going to be great. And I'm not trying to scold you guys at all. It's just like the it's a really great vibe here.
That said, do not make eye contact with Jonathan Coulton approaching at the time.
By the way, I just noticed I'm wearing the same shirt that I'm...
Jonathan, what you don't understand is Jonathan has a closet of 365 of those shirts.
It's just that kind of attention to detail to the JoCo Cruise.
It's like that's the action figure.
This is totally embarrassing. It's going to be exactly... It's going to look exactly like this tonight. So, all of you new monkeys are lucky because there's nothing new this year, apparently.
So we talked briefly about the show. As one other thing to mention, for the most part, we welcome any audio and video recording of the shows. They are generally released under a Creative Commons share-alike non-commercial license. That said, and we'll mention this again, some artists would prefer their sets not be recorded, or they may be recorded, but they ask that you not publicly repost them. We ask that you honor the wishes of any performer as such. For example, on the comedy night, we ask that nobody do any recording or reposting of said recording you're not supposed to do because of the nature of comedy. Also, the both performance this year, you are allowed to record, but please do not repost publicly until they have decided whether they think it's worthy of reposting. They're really, like, you don't understand, the more famous you are, the lower self-esteem you have. Those are the only restrictions we know of right now. We will try and give you all as much of a heads up as possible if any other shows have those kind of restrictions, so that you don't decide to skip one because there'll be plenty of film of it later and then you miss out. So.
Right. And please do honor those things. Again, it's just a case of just be cool. Nobody gets in trouble. Everybody's happy.
Let me see. A couple more things. We talked briefly about the game room. The game room is on deck 2, where you all went through registration. Sponsored by Seat Back 2 Games. That is open 24/7.
Woo!
It is generally divided into 2 sections. If you, as you walk in, the right side will always be dedicated to tabletop gaming, and we in fact will have several tables from Geek Chic.
Yeah.
During peak times, those tables will have some time limitations on them, but you are welcome to look at them and stroke them in a non-sexual manner. They're really awesome. The left half of the room is it's a conference center, so there's two smaller conference rooms that we dedicate towards some of these Shadow Cruise events. Like we say, you can sign up. So people are bringing video games there. We will have a full Artemis set up for those of you who are familiar with Artemis. That'll be in there a number of times, as we will have the apparently annual Celebrity Artemis, or Celebrity Drunk Artemis. There's also
For Celebrity Artemis, you scheduled the training.
Yeah, we have a training session, which is really mostly just set up a bar and point the celebrities at the computers and try and pretend they're going to know what they do when they get up here. That is a closed event. You're not allowed to watch us get drunk. You're only allowed to watch us while we are already drunk.
And crashing starships.
Many starships will crash. In fact, this year we will have one crew composed, at least partially, if not entirely, of actual crew members of the Independence of the Sea. It is mentioned in the Sea Monkey, but also, again, during the peak times, like the days we are at sea where everyone is stuck on board, the gaming room can get crowded. There are several overflow gaming areas. Basically, you can go wherever you want on the ship as long as you found space. That said, we have some dedicated spaces. Up on deck 14 in the aft, there's a bar called Olive or Twist. There are two rooms next to that, which are basically card rooms. One's called Cloud Nine, one's called Seven of Hearts. At various times during the days and evenings that those rooms are dedicated to us, you can find out when in the schedule. Also, this year, new for us, because we realize there's this huge room that doesn't get used until dinner time for the most part. So the Deck 5 dining room, on sort of the right and left sides as you go in, they're letting us just sort of clear off those tables, and you can do some overflow gaming there. There's also a few of the gaming track events in that room, because there's dozens of tables there and not being used, so now they're going to get used, damn it. We mentioned the Shadow Cruise events. We mentioned briefly there are these secondary events, the gaming track, the writing track, and the featured performers. As he mentioned, some of the performers will also have spontaneous or semi-spontaneous meetups, drink-ups. You are also welcome to schedule your own. There's sign-ups available down in the conference center if you just want to have a meetup of people from Ohio or something.
That sounds lame.
Yeah.
Well,
we really encourage and welcome. And we're amazed when it started happening, just sort of your ability to create your own fun, because it saves us from having to do it.
It's true. Easily 80% of the content of the spheres comes from you guys, so.
I think that covers. Oh, dinner! Dinner! Our dinner is scheduled every night in the dining room. I will again mention this during the cocktail party, but to get you used to it. Deck 3, the dining room. It's three decks of dining room because there's a lot of people. We have the entire deck 3 is dedicated to us. The seating plan is generally open seating for us. You all may have a table on your sea pass that says you're assigned to a certain table. Ignore that number. Basically, there will be three types of table tents in the room. You like how I grunted as I... The majority of the tables in the room will have these white table tents that say open seating on them. You may sit at any of those tables at any day. You can mix and match. There is a section in the middle towards the back of the room that will have these blue table tents. That's just for performers and staff. Please do not approach. Please do not make eye contact.
Don't eat off airplanes.
There are some people who requested fixed seating. They were supposed to get red table tents, but thanks to colors on the web not looking like they look in real life, they're getting sort of a rosy cream. But it does say, so watch and make sure that yours does not say fixed seating. Those people are people who requested the same seat for nights in a row. For example, if you have any dietary restrictions, it is probably a good idea, and it's easier for you and for your servers if you have the same table every night. So that said, you may sit in any of the open seating seats. You also are not required to come to dinner. It's not mandatory. It's fun and it's great to meet a bunch of other people, but there's plenty of other dining options on the ship, from the Windjammer Buffet, which is up on 11. There's a steakhouse, there's an Italian restaurant, there's a Johnny Rockets. And there is, of course, the infamous Sorrento's Pizza on deck 5.
Ooh.
best pizza in the world.
It is the best pizza on this ship. And it becomes exponentially more delicious as you get more hours past midnight.
The fewer other foods are actually available to you, the more tasty it becomes.
But those options are available. We will also mention that tomorrow night, which is Sunday night, and Thursday night, in the main dining room, and only in the main dining room, it is formal wear. They describe that as jacket and tie for men and formal dress for ladies. They are generally not super strict about it. Our rule of thumb, as we have mentioned in other places, is if you look like you are making an effort, you will probably be fine. That, for a formal night, that means if you have a shirt and a tie but not a jacket, you're probably fine. If you have a jacket but no tie but a nice shirt, you're probably fine. If you are wearing a dripping bathing suit and nothing else, you are probably not fine.
Make it on fire.
But that is also only for the main dining room. You can eat anywhere or be anywhere else on the ship, and formal wear is not required. And it is at the discretion of the dining room staff and the maitre d' as to whether or not your clothing is acceptable. We might think that a full-on Voltron cosplay counts as formal.
Certainly counts as making an effort.
Yeah.
Give it a bow tie. It'll be fine. Yeah.
And the rest is really just, as Jonathan said, this is your party. We're just here to make some noise at you every so often, but it is an unbelievable, wonderful vibe. People are so open and giving, and it's very easy to step in. Just find a thing you enjoy, and I guarantee you there are at least 12 other people on the ship that enjoy it as much as you do, and it is going to be a great, fun, week-long party of fruity drinks and gaming and not enough sleep.
Yay!
That said, we welcome any questions you have, especially the new people, if you're unfamiliar or unsure about anything.
Right here.
What's that? Photography, I will double check this. I believe photography will be okay. No flash photography. And again, we'll...
There's never been a performer who's said, please don't take pictures of them.
Yeah.
Just to consider the people around you, if you have a tripod and a rigging all this.
Yeah, that goes for all recording, basically. We're fine with it as long as you're not interfering with anybody else's enjoyment of the show with it or blocking any aisles. Yes, down here.
So there are two formal nights for dinner. Is there a dress code for the other
night? The other nights in the dining room, the question is, what is the dress code other than the formal nights in the dining room? They describe some of the nights as smart casual, some of the nights as something else. Essentially,
just wear pants.
Wear pants. Wear a shirt that is not ripped and has a picture of a Frank Frazetta naked lady on it.
And if you use your fork, you'll fit right in.
Yeah, generally, we have seen people get in with shorts, we have seen people get in with t-shirts, whether or not they have printing on them. We recommend that you just wear something like a grown-up might wear.
What's a grown-up?
And you'll be fine. No, I'm sorry. You didn't hear the air quotes when I said grown-up.
And this tends to get more casual as the week goes on.
Yeah. Here we go. Basically, wear something that, if your mom saw it, she wouldn't go, oh, honey. You should be.
Not no toe pass.
Again, it's up to the discretion of the dining staff, but they're generally pretty lenient if you're not looking sloppy. Define that term.
Any other questions?
One there. This is an interesting question.
This is an interesting question. Electric violin for karaoke.
One of the events, for those of you unfamiliar, is live band karaoke, where Jonathan plays a number of Jonathan's hits. And his background is a live band, and we have sign-ups for each song. The sign-up sheets will be available, I believe, at the info desk. And by random selection, a person for each song will get chosen to sing that song while Jonathan is standing 3 feet from them.
It just plugs in with a quarter-inch cable?
Yes.
Into a DI box?
Yes.
All right, let me, I have to talk to, I just have to talk to the sound guys and figure out, what's song? We'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
You have. No, your friend wants to qualify.
I guarantee you. By the time live band karaoke comes around, your band is gonna look like the Polyphonic Spree.
They look good.
Be more triangle and cymbal players.
I will say this. The thing about the live band karaoke is that we're just a trio. And this year, the person playing bass is Jim Boja, who is a musician and friend of mine who's on last year and on this year. And he is, he just learned the songs recently. So I will say that the live band karaoke is a little bit tricky because we need to hold it together because often the singer is not going to hold it together at all. No offense. So we'll see what we can work out about that. But it's an intriguing idea. And I'll check with the sound man. Wherever the sign up sheets are, you can talk to the person there. Let them know.
Make a note.
Your name. Make a note on one of the sheets or something.
Say,
like that.
We'll say plucky violin lady. I think we mentioned this, but just in case, to reiterate, by the way, we've said this other places. Your badges. These get you into all the JoCo Cruise events. Please make sure you have them with you. It makes it very easy for you to enter because they will not stop you and say, where the hell is your badge? If you lose your badge at any point during the week, first of all, panic. Because we are going to put you off the ship. But then find any helper monkey and say something along the lines of,
I lost my badge!
And they'll get you taken care of. But do try, please try to remember to have your badge with you because it is your ticket to all of our events. That goes for all the featured and writing track events. So you don't need to take this with you on shore.
Okay.
Unless you really want to.
Any other questions about how this big enchilada is eaten or prepared?
Sir, over here.
How many of us are there on this trip?
There are roughly, the total group this year is roughly 850.
The whole ship is something like, what is it, 3,500 passengers?
4,300 when it's maxed out.
43 maxed out.
25% of the ship. So you're going to see one another wherever you go.
Yeah. Oh, that's another thing I suppose to mention for the new people. There are a lot more of them than there are of us, so to speak. And they're early in the JoCo Cruise oeuvre. A term came about to describe the people who are not part of the JoCo Cruise called snorks. I don't know why. It came up, I think, as just a way to talk about other people without them knowing you were. Not that we're banning it or anything, but we tried to downplay that because it's really not an us versus them situation. There are plenty of really nice people on this ship. There's a lot of them who are very interested in what we're doing. And throughout the week, you may get asked when they see your badge, what is this JoCo Cruise group?
Who is a JoCo?
Is it dangerous? In fact, we have a lot of JoCo cruisers now who had just seen us on a ship in previous years and thought it looked like fun, and now they are one of us.
So please do be polite and welcoming and all that stuff. We don't want to be remembered as, you know, we don't want the story to be like, we were on vacation on the cruise ship and there was this group there and there were a bunch of jerks. We don't want that to be the story. So just be nice. We're all sharing this ship together and everything will work out fine.
In the back.
That is
live band karaoke is just my songs. That's right. There are plenty of other karaoke opportunities, a dozen songs or something like that. There will be sign up sheets in the
at the help desk right outside of the gator, sponsored by Steve Jackson.
Brought to you by Carl's Jr. Anyone else? Right there. You do not need your badge. The question is, if you're on a JoCo exclusive excursion, do you need your badge? You do not. You will have it. You'll be given
an excursion ticket.
If you have, or you signed up for an excursion, whether or not it's JoCo exclusive, then your ticket will be distributed to your cabin the night before, and that's all you need is that ticket.
But do keep track of those tickets.
Yes, do not lose them because that's your badge to get on the excursion. Right there.
Has the internet rate
Oh, yes. Good point. Internet. There is an internet package available on board. Its usual price is $229 for the week for unlimited internet.
Wow.
Welcome to the life on the high seas.
It does go to space, everybody. It does go to outer space. It's a little expensive. Sorry, it goes to outer space.
That's for unlimited Wi-Fi, up to two simultaneous machines running. The Wi-Fi is not broadband robust. It is generally pretty reliable, though, and it is certainly good for non-streaming activities. We have a special discounted rate for all JoCo Cruise people, which is $180 for the week. $50 savings to you. If you want to sign up for that, just sign up for the normal package, the normal $229 package, and by the end of the week, they have to do it manually, so it's a time-intensive process, but they will be manually applying that discount to your ship account. Keep an eye on it. You can check your account either by going to the front desk, or you can check your folio on your TV in your cabin. If by the last day of the cruise you have not seen that discount applied, you can go to the front desk and make sure they take care of that for you. Also, we've been asked to mention, once you sign up for the internet, it's non-refundable. So make sure you really want it.
And that's a general point, is that if you have questions about like ship operations things, you can ask the front desk, or you can call them. But if you have questions about the JoCo Cruise events, you can ask them, you can help the monkeys or any of us.
Is there an exact minute discount?
They do not. They've changed over from a per minute plan like that we've had previous years. In fact, most of the cruise lines are changing over to this new package-based plan only. I'm not positive if there is a per minute option available. If there is, we do not have a discount on it. We only have discounts on the package.
You can check in the, what's the name of the room where the computers are? It's called the
computer room.
The what?
It's the business center.
There is some room somewhere that has a bunch of computers in it. It's either above or below the library.
It's
over there. You can go to one of those computers and see what's available to you if there is a.
Yeah, it's by the pooter tube bar.
Yeah, it's by the pooter tube bar.
Anyone else? Yes. No such thing. Probably. The front desk is on deck 5, the promenade, i.e. the mall, at the back of the ship.
So if you see a high ceiling, that's the promenade, and then towards the back.
Just walk past the Ben and Jerry's to your right. Eventually, you hit the back of the ship, back up, turn to your left.
Oh, and we take this for granted, but on the ship, the front of the ship is the bow. The back is the back.
The ass of the ship. The ship ass.
The left side is known as port, and you can remember that. Left has four letters, port has four letters, which means that the right is starboard.
All of the maps and representations of the ships that you see on the wall are facing in the direction of the ship, which is a brilliant design idea that I might not have thought of if I had designed the ship. But if you're looking at a map of the ship on the wall and you see that it's pointing this way, the front is this way, that is the actual front of the actual ship. Very handy.
As far as we know, the ship does not have a crow's nest or a plank.
Oh.
Not yet, anyway.
Should they kill people?
At 2:40, just, and so as everyone knows,
yeah,
no, I'm telling them,
okay.
It's 2:40.
Sorry, you didn't see his fire.
You know you killed him, Mark?
I'm sorry. I love you. Two things. First of all, this is more important, so Storm said it, and we're going to say it all week long. Wash your hands. Wash your hands there with soap. There's also hand sanitizer stations pretty much all over this damn ship. They stress it. It's actually important. We have not, to date, had a JoCo poop cruise, and we do not wish to have one.
I perversely am weirdly looking forward to the day. I feel like it would be kind of amazing.
Yeah, you're crapping in a bag.
No, I would feel like it's time that there would be a lot of great stories.
Yeah, it's true. That time in the war.
Maybe not everyone on the ship is going to do that. We will have herd immunity.
That's right. Do wash your hands. It's all those stations with the sanitizers. Use them like crazy. Use them until your skin is raw and chapped.
And the second thing, so you're aware of the schedule today, At 3 o'clock in Studio B is the welcome reception. It is an hour-long open bar.
Featuring beer specially brewed for JoCo Cruise by Mr.
We'll say a number of the same things we've said here, just more quickly, in front of more people, but you'll already know, so you can be all smug. Be like, yeah, that's right. I know where we're sitting. We're not sitting in the dining room. And you will meet all of your performers for the evening, and then immediately following that event, there will be a mandatory safety drill. Everybody goes through it. Deal with it. Sail away happens roughly 5 o'clock, and then dinner, again, is at 6 in the main dining room, deck 3. And then, at 9 o'clock, the Jonathan Coulton Super Bad Big Old Band Rock Show. And featuring the famous Jonathan Coulton Stripey shirt.
This is right here on show day.
As opposed to the other Jonathan Coulton Stripey shirt.
Shut up, Polo.
And well, ladies and gentlemen, it's 2 folds up from the wrist. 2 folds only. Yeah. Below the elbow, not above.
That's the official salute.
2 buttons down, 2 folds up equals Jonathan Coulton.
Everyone do it.
If you knew like how many striped shirts I wear with 2 buttons down and 2 folds up,
that's how you wear a striped shirt.
Since you started, all I want to be is you, Jonathan.
Because I look amazing.
You do. And then immediately following that is actually our Welcome New Monkeys mixer. Basically, just hang out, continue to drink. All of the old monkeys are encouraged to welcome all of you new monkeys so that you're all mingled like a stew. Yeah. I don't like that metaphor, and I'm going to start it.
Mingled like a stew.
potatoes. And,
I get it.
Like a tasty stew.
Tasty stew.
A tasty, attractive, sexy stew.
Please do not eat the stew.
That's the way to get the joke.
And unless there are any other questions, please feel free to chime out.
Maybe.
That's up to you guys, yeah. You can't force a meme, sir.
Yes, definitely.
I understand there's some type of puzzle hunt on the cruise. Do you know?
There is a puzzle hunt. I don't have any details about it. Chances are the trailhead will begin in the game room.
I have details on that.
Oh, puzzle hunt.
Thank you!
The trailhead does indeed begin in the game room. It'll start tomorrow, roughly midnight-ish tonight to tomorrow morning.
So does that mean 12 midnight tonight or 11:59 p.m. tomorrow night?
Does it mean
a minute after 11:59 p.m. I am just messing with you. When a man loves a woman very much.
I'm giving you a bit of stars.
Shows her his trailhead?
By the way, at some point we are going to cross a time zone and I am going to totally screw up how that happens.
So sorry, there's a green button.
Look for somebody with a green button like this. There's 6 or 8 of us, and we will provide puzzles for you.
Yay!
So the game room is sponsored by Steve Jackson. At midnight tonight, look for the people with the green buttons. They will point you to the trailhead of the puzzle.
Starting at midnight tonight and throughout tomorrow. Yes.
Do not look for the green people with buttons. They are aliens who are trying to probe you.
What's wrong with that?
To Johnny Rockets.
Any other questions? Right there.
Ship's time
does change. That is a question because we do change over to a time zone partway through.
We actually sailed beside itinerary in December, and when we did, they actually sent a little card around a turn down. Each night they'll present little cards. And it will indicate, do not ask us, because we always mess it up.
But yes.
Yes, sir. Is there a clock by which one might learn the time?
All the touchscreen boards have clocks on them.
That is a great idea.
All of the electronic maps that are dotted about the hallways have the ship's time on it.
And they do make announcements.
Yeah.
To let you know when it's happening. The thing that always happens is that you put your phone in airplane mode so you don't pay all of the exorbitant charges, and then it never knows to change the time. And you look at what time it is, and then you're off by an hour all of a sudden.
And I believe, like everybody has their television screen, one of the channels has ship's information. and it'll present.
You know what? Everybody is so paranoid about it now that all you're going to hear is people talking about the for 36 hours before it happens.
So it's all the Facebook group talked about for a second.
I think we're going to gather up on the top deck at 2 a.m. the night it changes, and then we're going to sacrifice a farm animal.
Is that an official event?
It's a marshmallow farm. Any other questions? Down over here. You, sir. Yes. Bearded sir, in the back, and then you in front of him.
Bearded sir in front.
Yeah, I'm afraid because the game room is in such demand, as much as I suggested, that we can't allow people who are not part of the official cruise, because it wouldn't be fair to everybody who's bigger than us.
That said, you may feel free to take games out of the game room and come and play with them elsewhere on the ship. It's just, as I said, it's a premium. It gets shower people. That's all we're going to say. Gets a little gamey in there. Yeah. Later in
the game room.
I didn't even mean that. I hate myself so much.
This gentleman with the sunglasses on his head.
You can wear a fez anytime you want. But we have the Paul F. Tompkins Memorial Fez Extravaganza. Which will be taking place
later in the week.
Yeah,
Monday.
It's in the schedule.
Tomorrow. You don't have to wait very long.
Is tomorrow the best extravaganza?
Yeah. It is. Look at the schedule.
Generally, people have been wearing them on the formal nights, one or the other, or both. But really, you could wear it anytime.
You will see people wearing fezzes throughout the week.
The fezzes are cool. Did you still have a question somewhere over here?
Yes.
You can still sign up for shore excursions if there are space available, either JoCo exclusive or regular ones. You can go to the shore excursions desk, which is right next to the front desk, which again is on deck 5 aft. If there is space available, they will be happy to take care of you and sign you up for it. We should also mention there are a couple of excursions, the JoCo exclusives, where we have not yet met the minimum number required for them. I don't know which ones they are offhand. If by 24 hours before that excursion we haven't met the minimum, they will either give you the option of getting it folded into an existing other departure time, if there are other departure times, or they may be forced to, on a couple of the excursions, cancel it. The ship will let you know ahead of time what that deal is. If they cancel it or you decide you do not want to move to the other time, they'll issue you a full refund. That said, we're in no danger of meeting the minimum on the Arecibo tour.
Arecibo!
That is happening. Any question? Any more questions?
Yes.
There is not a waiting list. At least we have no way of because it's run through the ship system. We can't coordinate a wait list with them. Or we couldn't pre-cruise certainly because they would just, if somebody canceled, they'd just automatically make those tickets available. So we couldn't deal with that. So we don't have one going on our end. I would just suggest checking in regularly, or if maybe someone wants to auction off their seats. That's really the only thing you can do.
Auction off your seats.
And again, if you really want, I don't mean this derisively when I say if you really want to go, and it is super cool, we went, and it is really wonderful. If it means enough to you that you really want to go, you can just go on your own. You can find a transportation company, and we can look into trying to find one, make sure they're reputable. And you can just hire them, and you can go, and you can pay your own admission and go. It's going to be crowded with lots of other sea monkeys, and you won't be on the official tour, but you can still do that with tours like that. That is an option that's available.
Down here.
Yep. Okay. Right. That's the Arecibo Observatory is the big radio telescope that's built into a valley in Puerto Rico in Arecibo, the one that was in GoldenEye and Contact.
Woo!
And there was a shore excursion. We knew it was nearby, and we actually had them specially set it up for us because it's not a usual excursion. And we started out with 200 tickets, which sold out in a day.
Yeah.
And we had them add another 100 tickets, which sold out in another half a day.
Yeah, unfortunately, a popular destination.
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing. It's usually not. When we told them that there were 200 people coming, they just... So basically, you know, we had the choice of putting together an excursion that we knew maybe not everybody was interested to go, but to be able to provide that experience. So
it's you know, it's just capacity issues on the museum. We would love to have made 800 tickets available, but that was the amount of capacity they could comfortably offer to us. But if you are interested in going, it is about an hour and a quarter or so there and an hour and a quarter back, and we're only in San Juan 7 a.m. till 2 p.m. So if you want to do that, you got to get out early and get back quickly. Don't linger too long. You've got enough time to really see everything, but you can't stick around for 4 hours going, whoa.
And
I
had a question right here.
Okay. Is there any official organized sports ball activity going on
That's the question. Is the Super Bowl showing on the ship? There is. The ship is showing the Super Bowl in Studio B. At the normal time. We will also say that it is not the regular CBS feed, so we don't think you're going to see the Super Bowl commercials. You might see other commercials. We don't know. It's some sort of international feed. They might have them, they might not, but we can't guarantee you. You'll see the cute puppy getting saved by the horses from the coyote.
I bet you can find those commercials online after the fact.
You can already find most of them online.
Yeah, they're already there.
But if you want to put together a Super Bowl shadow event, that's something that you can do. That's exactly
right. There are plenty of sea monkeys who are planning to go watch the Super Bowl.
Pirate in the back.
We are not in charge of the puppy bowls.
Sorry. Also no kitten bowl. I mean, they exist, we're just not going to be able to watch them.
Open our hearts.
Anyone else? It's 253.
Ranger.
That is a very good question. Sometimes they found it difficult to join games in the game room. Sometimes it's unclear whether or not you can join a game. They have at least one sea monkey has printed up a number of signs that actually say open seating or come join us. You were encouraged to indicate that somehow, either with those signs or make your own if you're gaming in the game room, to let people know you are welcome to come join their game. And sometimes it's just as easy as asking. Again, everyone's cool on this trip, and you can, you know, oh, can I join? Is that okay? And maybe they're in the middle of thing, and maybe you can't, but I'd be willing to bet more often than not, they'd be happy to let you in. They're just so into their game that they're not paying attention in their periphery that someone really wants to join them. So feel free to just go up and ask.
Yeah, almost every time people might be playing a game and they'd be very happy that they're infecting other people with that.
And if they won't let you in their game, just flip the table and walk away.
And they have more table protectors here. Do not flip the Geek Chic tables. Repeat after me or with me.
Do not flip the Geek Chic tables.
Excellent. You all get the note.
Unless you want to immediately pull out your checkbook.
Which you might want to do anyway, but not after flipping the table.
Any other questions?
Yes, young lady.
Yes.
Monarch of the Seas will be crowned
this evening before the show. The Monarch of the Seas is randomly selected from all of the sea monkeys, except for those who's selected to opt out from selection. The Monarch of the Seas is randomly selected, so they and the consort of their choice and or their family immediately become royalty, which is awesome. Yeah? They get super awesome crowns. They get seats down front center for every show. And you are encouraged to address them during any time they are wearing their regalia as Your Highness, Your Majesty, My Liege.
They also gain laser vision and the ability to fly. Woo!
And they get to decide who lives and who dies.
I think we are running up against our time.
We are, yeah.
We are. Thank you guys so much for being here. Welcome. It's been an amazing week. Any further questions, ask the Helper Monkeys, ask for the Sea Monkeys. We're all going to take care of each other. It's going to be fantastic.
Let's go get drinks.
Happy cruise.
Let's go get drinks.
Yes. There's drinks on this ship? Score.
So how do we get...